kids, in this video lecture I am going to tell about lactoprone. Lactoprone means lactose oprone. It was given by Jacob and Monod. It is a inducible oprone. Inducible oprone means it activates when the lactose is present. In the presence of lactose, it acts as activator. So it's a inducible oprone. Components. Its components are mainly promoter, operator and structural gene. It has also regulator gene, but it is a not a part, but this gene is not part of oprone. First case, in absence of lactose. Before that, I want to tell you that lactose, what is the need of lactose in our cell or in bacterial cell or E. coli cell? Need of lactose. Lactose is a disaccharide. When it dissociates, it gives glucose and galactose. And we know that our energy source is glucose. So, it is a main purpose of it. In first case, in absence of glucose, if glucose is absent, if lactose is absent, in absence of lactose, if the lactose is absent, when the lac-I gene is present, lac-I gene bind with the operator site and it halt the process because it will not allow RNA polymerase to continue unwinding. RNA polymerase is a main transcriptional enzyme which unwind and responsible for transcription. If it will not unwind and transcription will not occur, then the no mRNA is formed. But in the presence of lactose, if lactose is present, then at activator site of, then the activator site of this regulatory gene or repressor gene, lactose is bind. When lactose bind, it will not bind with the operator. If it not bind with the operator, then the RNA polymerase can continue its process. Then it form structural gene into mRNA. Okay, it has mainly three structural genes, Z, Y, A. Z give rise to beta galactosidase, Y give rise to permease, and A give rise to transacetylase. Okay, then its function. Main function of beta galactosidase is to break lactose into glucose and galactose. What is the function of permease? Permease make the membrane more permeable to lactose. If the membrane is more permeable, then the more lactose will come, and the more glucose, then it convert into more glucose. Then transacetylase. Transacetylase function is still not clear. So in absence of lactose, oprone is off, and in presence of lactose, oprone is on. If mutation in lac-I, then the no repressor found. If the no repressor is found, then the structural gene will express, because no inducer is produced, then the no repressor will bind to the operator. If no repressor is bind to the operator, then the operator is free, and RNA pole 2 and RNA polymerase 2 can perform its function. So it is a constitutive expression, because it's then the process is continuously going on. What is the glucose effect? If the glucose is more in amount, then E. coli has tendency to take glucose first, then lactose. It will first consume glucose, then lactose. Okay, it will first consume glucose and then lactose. On the basis of it dioxic growth curve is formed. This dioxic growth curve formed lac phase of E. coli due to glucose and then due to lactose. Thank you so much.